Hello guys, welcome back in today's video. In this video, I am having a great lesson for you. A lesson is related to the Second World War. This is an incident which happened after the World War II. Like at that time, Japan was also in war, and most of Japanese wanted to surrender. They have come to the end. But at that time, what happens? There is one group of people which is really courageous in Japan, that's called the samurai. So they wanted to fight. What happened? There was one aeroplane from American army. They have left there, and what they did, they took that aeroplane and flew away in a one jungle. In that jungle, there was a one ancient tribe, and the tribe could not relate it. They have seen something in flying in sky. They call it air bird. So when they saw in person, they couldn't relate it with it, whether it's the air bird or something else. After that, there was one person came. He said, "It's look like a vehicle. Obviously, it is having two tires." So he said, "Let's use it, this vehicle." They started pulling this vehicle with the help of bullock cart with two horses. So they were start using it as kind of bullock cart. But after some time, there was one person had come there, and he said he had been to city, so he knows how to use it. So he said, "I have been to city and I know how this thing is used. You don't need to add these horses for carrying, for dragging this thing. And it's not even a bullock cart, it's a vehicle. And it can be run by with the help of fuel." So he went to city, he come along with fuel, and he start the aeroplane with the fuel. And they started running that one aeroplane like a car. So they were driving every single day as like a car. After some days, what happens? There is a one more person come. He had also been city. And you will wonder, he was even pilot. So he said, "This thing can make you fly." So he said, "It's not can be used as a car, so we can use it as a air bird." So they said, "This is an air bird." He said, "Obviously, it is an air bird. And after that, he took all those people from the tribe, and he had given a ride to them in the sky. So consider this story. It's one kind of analogy, philosophical as well. You can consider it any context. I was listening Osho, so from there I got this story. I'm sharing the source as well. All credit goes to Osho. I'm just sharing the story. So what you need to do? Meditation is a technique. It is a device. You need to use it in order to declutter yourself, to make yourself clean, cleanse your inner being. Because you are collecting every single day, collecting every single day. It's same as like the example of aeroplane. Like some people use it as a bullet cord. But if you will start releasing it, so it will not be bullet cord. Next thing, what you can do, when you are doing this thing, when you are not collecting every single day whatever you got getting, you are leaving as well. So then you will use it as like a car. It can run, this car can be run, like thoughts will not be there, like something like it will happen. And then the nature of your energy, the vital energy, is goes up from Muladhara to Sastrarth. So it will reach there. But so then your, I would like to quote here also, you will become, you become a bird in the inner sky. Then you will become a bird in the inner sky. Because that the more you will spend time yourself, the more you will be contented, and the more your life will become blissful. And as like in through aeroplane, you can see a greater view. So you will be able to see a greater view of life. The thing is that you are having everything, but you don't have yourself. I want all the people to be luxurious, so they can be fed up at the end of the day with these things. How longer they will earn? Like a poor person will really less think about these meditational things. He need to take care of bread, he need to take care of his children's medicine. So those who have become contented, you can say, by using all materialistic pursuit, he can come to spirituality, he can ask the meaning of life, he can come to inner side. Well, thanks a lot for listening to me. At the end of the discourse, I would like to do Pranam, that eternal power was sitting in you.